In this video, we will learn how to edit solid objects. You can extrude, move, rotate, offset, taper, copy, delete, and color the faces of a solid using the Solid Edit tool. This tool is used to modify the geometry of a 3D object and apply changes without having to delete and recreate it. The Solid Edit tool consists of a variety of options which we will learn one by one in the current lesson. The first Solid Edit option is the Extrude Faces tool. This tool is similar to the Extrude tool, except that it is applied to the surfaces of 3D solid objects. By extruding faces, we can extend the surface in the direction of the X, Y, or Z axis. The Extrude Faces tool can be found in the Solid Editing panel of the Home ribbon. Alternatively, you can type Solid Edit in the command line, press Enter, select Face, and then select Extrude. Once the tool is active, I have to select the surface I want to extrude. So I will select the desired surface and press Enter. Then I have to specify the height of the extrusion. Positive values extend the face of the object in the direction of its normal, increasing its volume, while negative values extend the surface in the opposite direction, reducing the volume of the object. In this example, I will type 1 and press Enter. Next, I need to specify the angle of taper for the extrusion. This angle can be between minus 90 and 90 degrees. Tapering the selected surface with a positive angle tapers the face in, and a negative angle tapers the face out. The default angle is 0 degrees and extrudes the surface perpendicular to its plane. In the following image, you can see an object whose front face is extruded with a positive angle value on the left, and an object whose front face is extruded with a negative angle value on the right. In this example, I will type 30 and press Enter twice to deactivate the tool and see the final result. At this point, I will activate the tool again to see the other options. When I select the Face option, three more options appear in the command line. The Undo option cancels the selection of the faces you added most recently to the selection set. The Remove option removes previously selected faces from the selection set. With the Add option, you can add faces to the selection set. Finally, the All option selects all faces and adds them to the selection set. Now I will select the face I want and press Enter. Then, instead of typing a value to specify the height of extrusion, I will select the Path option. As its name suggests, with this option you can set a path for the extrusion based on a specified line or curve. All the profiles of the selected face are extruded along the chosen path to create the extrusion. Now all I have to do is select the path and press Enter twice to deactivate the tool and see the result. Let's move on to the Taper Faces tool. As its name indicates, this tool tapers faces on a 3D solid at a specified angle. The rotation of the taper angle is determined by the selection sequence of the base point and second point along the selected vector. The Taper Faces tool can be found in the Solid Editing panel of the Home ribbon. Alternatively, you can type Solid Edit in the command line, press Enter, select Face, and then select Taper. Once the tool is active, I have to select the faces I want to taper first. So I will select the face and press Enter once. Next, I have to specify the base point, so I will click on the lower corner of the face to define it. Then, I have to specify another point to set the orientation of the axis that determines the direction of the taper. So I will use the reference line that appears to define the taper's direction. Lastly, I have to specify the taper angle. To define the angle, I will type 10 and press Enter. Since I achieved the desired result, I will press Enter twice to deactivate the tool. Now I will repeat the same procedure for another surface. I will activate the tool, select the face and press Enter. Next, I will set a base point for the taper's orientation on the axis, and then I will click again to define the taper's direction on the Z-axis. Finally, I will type 15 and press Enter to define the taper angle. To see the final result, I will press Enter twice. In the next example, I will show you the Move Faces tool. This tool moves the selected faces on a 3D solid object to a specified height or distance. The Move Faces tool can be found in the Solid Editing panel of the Home ribbon. Alternatively, you can type Solid Edit in the command line, press Enter, select Face, and then select Move. Once the tool is active, I have to select the faces I want to move. So I will select the face and press Enter once. Next, I have to specify the base point of displacement. This time, I will set the base point in the center of the circle. Then, to specify the second point of displacement, I will click on another point of the object. Lastly, I will press Enter twice to deactivate the tool and see the final result. Next comes the Copy Faces tool, with which you can copy the faces of 3D objects. The Copy Faces tool can be found in the Solid Editing panel of the Home ribbon. Alternatively, you can type Solid Edit in the command line, press Enter, select Face, and then select Copy. Once the tool is active, I have to select the faces I want to copy. So I will select the face and press Enter once. Next, I have to specify the base point of displacement. So I will click on the lower left corner of the surface to specify it. Then, I have to specify the second point of displacement. I will use the reference line to define the direction and click to copy the face. To deactivate the tool and see the final result, I will press Enter twice. In the next example, we will learn how to use the Offset Faces tool. As the tool's name indicates, it offsets faces equally by a specified distance or through a specified point. A negative value increases the size or volume of a surface, while a positive value decreases the size or volume of a surface. The Offset Faces tool can be found in the Solid Editing panel of the Home ribbon. Alternatively, you can type Solid Edit in the command line, press Enter, select Face, and then select Offset. Once the tool is active, I have to select the faces I want to offset. I will select the inner face of the hole and press Enter. Next, I need to specify the offset distance, so I will type minus 0.6 and press Enter. To deactivate the tool, I will press Enter twice. Notice that the size of the hole increased. In the next example, we will learn about the Delete Faces tool, which removes faces including fillets and chamfers. Simply put, this tool restores the object to its original form. The Delete Faces tool can be found in the Solid Editing panel of the Home ribbon. Alternatively, you can type Solid Edit in the command line, press Enter, select Face, and then select Delete. Once the tool is active, I have to select the faces I want to delete. I will select the inner face of the hole and press Enter. The moment I pressed Enter, the surface was deleted. I will press Enter twice to deactivate the tool, and I will proceed to remove another surface of the same solid. So I will activate the tool again, select the cellular surface and press Enter 3 times to deactivate the tool and see the final result. The next option is the Rotate Faces tool. This command rotates one or more faces of a 3D solid object about a specified axis. The Rotate Faces tool can be found in the Solid Editing panel of the Home ribbon. Alternatively, you can type Solid Edit in the command line, press Enter, select Face, and then select Rotate. Once the tool is active, I have to select the face I want to rotate. I want to select the inner faces of the rectangular hole, so I will rotate the view using the Orbit tool to select all the faces and press Enter. Next, I have to specify the axis of rotation. The default option for specifying the axis of rotation is to define two points. In this example, I will set the first point at a corner at the base of the object and the second point at the top corner of the object. Lastly, I need to specify the rotation angle. So I will type 20 and press Enter. Then I will press Enter twice to deactivate the tool. Notice how the shape has changed. Last but not least, I will show you how the Color Faces tool works. This tool changes the color of faces. Colored faces can be used to highlight details within a complex 3D solid model. The Color Faces tool can be found in the Solid Editing panel of the Home ribbon. Alternatively, you can type Solid Edit in the command line, press Enter, select Face, and then Color. Once the tool is active, I will select the faces I want to color and press Enter. Once I do, the Select Color dialog appears. Personally, I will select the magenta color and press OK. Then, I will press Enter twice to deactivate the tool. Now the upper face of the solid is magenta. At this point, I should mention that colored faces are visible when you select the conceptual, realistic, shaded, or shaded with edges visual styles.